gonna share with you really quickly what I've been working on for some different teams and teachers that I work with around the idea of data analysis of a task that students complete. I am basing this work off of this fantastic book, Driven by Data 2.0. And here's what I'm developing that teachers are going to work through. So before they even get to the data meetings that we're going to work on student tasks, I have prepared this protocol. And the process is the teachers are going to select a key standard and they're going to determine what mastery looks like using what's called a no-show chart. So I give them a couple of examples. We have the standard listed. What do we want all students to know? What do we want students to show us that they know that? What do they need to show us that they can do? Then you select a task. Now this has to be a common task among the entire team. And they are all going to give students this task to give them an opportunity to demonstrate their knowledge from the no-show chart. So this is an example of one that an English team did when they're working on theme. They want students to be able to write the theme, or a theme statement rather, provide evidence, and then give elaboration. The next phase is that then they will establish a rubric. So it's important to note on this one, they are only establishing the highest level of the rubric and the lowest level of the rubric. We are going to fill in the middle two whenever we start to analyze the data. Now, just to note, this is not to give a grade. This is just for an analysis of learning for the students. So this isn't something that students will see in advance. They don't need the rubric to be complete yet. Step four, the team works together and they come up with an exemplar response to that student task. So they are doing the work that the students are doing so that they can see what a really great model looks like before they ever even assign it to their students. With this one, it's a neat idea. If you can have them do a slightly different variation, for instance, this team of teachers worked with a topic that will not be an option for students to use. They're given a choice of three different topics for them to write their theme statements on. So there's an example here. Not only do the teachers have it whenever they start analyzing student work, but they are also going to have this available to share with students as an example of what a great piece of writing or a great piece of work looks like for the task. And then lastly, to prepare the teachers for the next meeting, they have to establish expectations for the next meeting. They're going to confirm that any tasks or assessments that are going to be assigned and discussed at the data meeting. They are going to input any scores that they have onto a spreadsheet that we use, not covered with this, but that's part of what they do. And then they will gather four student samples each. Each teacher will bring some that represent patterns of high, medium, and low work on that comment.